exercise makes you thinner and does all sorts of other stuff, but who cares about that? Because it makes your brain stronger too. Hey guys, Trace here for DNews. We all know that exercise is good for us. Getting off the couch and onto the treadmill strengthens our muscles, increases blood flow, gives us energy, and of course, burns fat so that we can actually fit into those skinny jeans. For most people, this is more than enough incentive to hit the gym. But for some of us, particularly those stay-at-home and read types, or those of us who are less sporty, health and fitness alone isn't enough reason to slap on the spandex. But there is another benefit. Exercise could also strengthen your brain, particularly your memory. A new study out of Radboud University in the Netherlands gathered three groups of random participants and asked each to look at the same set of images. The first group did a somewhat strenuous 35-minute workout immediately after. The second group did the same exercise 4 hours later. And the third didn't exercise at all. Yay, control group. 2 days later, all the participants retook that image test, and those in the second group, who had that 4-hour delay before they exercised, were able to recall the most images. This suggests that regular exercise may improve long-term memory, that is, the ability to recall anything from more than just a few minutes ago. The catch? The exercise must happen around the time the memory is formed. According to researchers, this is because when you work out, your brain releases neurotransmitters, like dopamine and noradrenaline, that help your brain consolidate your memories. If these chemicals are absent when your brain absorbs information, that information is thought to decay more rapidly. This suggests that regular exercise may improve long-term memory, that is, the ability to recall anything from more than just a few minutes ago. But here's where things get tricky. The participants in that first group, who worked out immediately after the test, they recalled about the same number of images as those who didn't work out at all in the control group. This means that your ability to remember things depends not just on if you work out, but when you work out. That is, a short delay between the moment your brain logs that information and when you get onto the treadmill could be crucial to your ability to recall that information. Of course, more research is needed, so scientists can't yet say for sure whether delayed exercise leads to better memory. But when it comes to exercise as a direct cause of increased cognitive ability, scientists are pretty much in agreement that it does help. This is because exercise releases hormones that reduce inflammation and insulin resistance, as well as stimulating the growth of cells and blood vessels in your brain, making it, in a sense, stronger. Some studies have even suggested that the parts of the brain that control your memory, the prefrontal cortex and the medial temporal cortex, are larger in people who regularly exercise. The best part about it, you can just be the same old lazy you, apart from 2 hours of moderate exercise a week. 2 hours a week, that could mean walking your dog for a half hour every other day, riding your bike to work, or playing 18 holes on the weekend. Harvard researchers even count household activities like raking leaves or intense floor mopping, seriously, that's a quote, as exercise. Basically, as long as you break out in a light sweat, it counts. And the key to unlocking these benefits, at least in a long-term sense, is regularity. To do that, fitness experts recommend group fitness classes or personal trainers because you're more likely to follow an exercise regime that is scheduled. When your exercise becomes routine, your memory strengthens, and soon enough, forgetting to work out will no longer be a viable excuse. You know what's not exercise, though? Sex. Sorry, every human ever. If you want to know why, check out this video here. According to their data, jogging burns 276 calories in 30 minutes for men and 213 for women. That's about 9.2 and 7.1 calories per minute for each, respectively. A 25-minute sexual session, on the other hand, that's only going to burn about 100 calories for men and 76 for women. How do you guys get off the couch and exercise? Let us know in the comments. Make sure you subscribe so you get more DNews, and thanks for watching.